are here to enforce His victory over the enemy. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. And they overcame Him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives to the death. The scripture is telling us that the brethren, God's people, will overcome the adversary, which is the devil, by the blood of the Lamb. That means they are walking in that finished work of Christ on the cross. And it's that finished work of Christ on the cross where He has shed His precious blood. Through that, we overcome, we overpower, we put underneath our feet the enemy, the devil. That means we are enforcing that victory. So Christ on the cross, as we have been talking this entire week, has won the victory over the enemy. He has crushed the head of the serpent. He has destroyed the one who had the power of death. He has disarmed principalities and powers. He has cast out the ruler of this age. He has now in His possession all authority in heaven and earth. Now, what should you and I do as believers? We walk in that victory and we enforce it over the enemy. That's what God's people do. You see, in your own life, when the enemy comes against you, when there are evil spirits troubling you, you stand firm in the finished work of Christ on the cross, and on that basis, you resist the devil. You say, devil, no place here. You are an intruder. You have been expelled. You have been cast out. You have been crushed. You have been destroyed. You've been disarmed. So I resist your works. You have no right over my life, over the blessings that God has for me to walk in, over the goodness that God wants to put in my life. The devil will not touch that. We overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. That means we need to testify with our mouth what the finished work of Christ has done for us. What Christ has done for us by His blood, we testify with our mouth that finished work. You know, in Luke 10 and verse 19, Jesus said, He told His disciples, I'm giving you authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing will by any means hurt you. You see, He spoke this ahead of time, prior to the cross. And how much more you and I can walk in that promise or in that statement of truth now that the cross has taken place. That He said, I'm giving you authority over all the power of the enemy, over everything the devil can do, you and I walk in authority over. And He said, the devil will by no means hurt you. You see, that's the place of a believer. A believer is walking in the finished work of Christ on the cross. He is walking with Satan crushed underneath His feet. He is walking against enemy that's been destroyed, disarmed, and expelled. He is walking in the authority of Christ Himself. And He is walking in a manner which the enemy cannot hurt Him. You see, you and I have no reason to fear the enemy. We have no reason to be defeated. Let's walk in Christ's triumph. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank You for what You've completed for us through Your cross. Help us to walk in it. And right now, I extend my faith to everyone listening, and I break off and rebuke every evil work of the enemy that may be affecting them or coming against them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank You, Father. You help us walk in that victory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.